Could you tell us your name, your age, and which country you represent?
My name is Ruslan Ponomarev. I'm 30 years old and represent Ukraine here on Chess Olympiad on second board.
And at what age did you learn the rules of chess, and who taught you?
As I remember, I was around 7 and my dad explained me how to play, and we played first games against each other.
And what town or city did you grow up in?
Well, I was born in Gorlovka. This is Donetsky region, near border with Russia. But then, when I was 10 years old, I moved to another city, Kramatorsk, which is something like 50 kilometers from Gorlovka. And there I started to study chess more seriously, more professionally.
And is that where you still live?
Well, then after next 10 years, I moved to capital of Ukraine, to Kyiv, because it's more comfortable in general to live and to travel. And now, after another 10 years, okay, less 10 years, I'm married, and my wife from Bilbao, and we are living in Bilbao now.
How do you find chess culture in Bilbao compared to the Ukraine?
Well, I think chess is quite popular in País Vasco, in Bilbao, but maybe not so professional, because it's quite difficult to dedicate your life for professional chess, but it's lots of fun just to play, and everyone probably knows that many special chess events were organized in Bilbao. Organizers always wanted to do something special. This year, for example, would be European Club Cup and also Grand Slam to get in same room.
And going back to how you learnt chess, when you were learning chess, who was your chess hero? Who did you look up to?
Well, when I was 7 years old, I found in the library of my dad one book. There was so many beautiful games with, and most of them was games of the world chess champions.
Any particular world champion you liked?
Well, in general, I just like the games because they were so, it was specially selected for the book, and also there was some nice paintings, like not only chess moves, but also some, I don't know, was painted like soldiers and some armies. So I don't know, I tried to copy a little bit in my games, but okay, it was not so successful to copy. And then, okay, I started to study.
And you're a professional chess player, but if you hadn't been a professional chess player, what do you think you might have become? Which job, which profession?
I don't know, difficult question. Somehow, when I finished high school and thought to which university to go, where to study, and when I was 18 years old, I became world chess champion. So, okay, I thought if I'm not so bad in chess, maybe it's not so bad idea dedicate life to chess. But I don't know if not chess, I don't know, maybe I like a little bit science, I don't know, to study something.
You became FIDE World Chess Champion in 2001, is that correct?
I think we played in against Ivanchuk in January 2002. It started 2001, but second stage.
Do you have a special memory from that time? Was there one particular game which sticks in your memory?
Well, I remember it was totally unexpected for me. And somehow, deeply inside, I didn't change so much, but life around me changed it a lot. I don't know. It was such a mess.
In a good way, or
also in a good way, but also it was in some lots of mess, which I didn't like. It was quite difficult to concentrate.
Do you mean the kind of mess in chess politics? Is this what you mean?
I mean also lots of people started to recognize me in my hometown. More attention, I don't know.
Was that pleasant when you were 18, 19?
Okay, maybe it's pleasant, but for me it was very unexpected. For example, when I returned back home from Moscow to my hometown, to Kramatorsk, like on the railway station, lots of people met me with the flowers, I don't know. And I thought, oh my God, what's this? So if I will go to my flat, they will be also there. How am I supposed to live? But okay, I mean, some time passed and it became more calm. But I mean, yeah, it was not so easy to like people started to, I don't know, maybe think about me something differently. But personally, I just wanted to enjoy chess to improve, but yeah, it's not so easy when especially you are young, not so experienced in your life.
Very good. Now, one final question. If you were able to vote in the FIDE presidential election, who would you choose, Kirzan or Gary?
Well, personally, I'm in favor for changes, and I don't think like Kasparov like is such a perfect candidate, but just I don't know. I really want to see some changes, some new fresh blood in chess. And if choose between two, probably I would choose for Garry Kasparov.
Ruslan, thank you very much.